Dear students, in the previous video, I have given the problems on first form of equation of plane. So in this video, I am going to discuss second form of equation of plane, and this derivation, it is very important for your annual examination for 5 marks, and also we will solve some of the examples in this video. Now consider that result or the derivation. The vector equation of a plane passing through a point having position vector small a and having n vector as normal to the plane is r minus a dot n vector is equal to 0. So this is the second derivation of equation of plane. So in this one here, that plane passing through a point and which is having normal, that is n vector, right? So that now consider the proof. So here we have to consider three dimensional space which is having x, y, z axis. Now consider a point A on that plane, and also normal to the plane here, that is n vector, means that normal is a vector which is perpendicular to the plane, so that is n vector. Consider any point P on the plane. So this is the point on the plane. So remember some of the points here. OP vector, which is position vector of the point P, so this can be taken as here r vector. OA vector, which is position vector of the point A, this can be taken as here small a vector. Already it is given as small a vector. So what condition should be satisfied to say that point P is always on the line on the plane here? Now that two vectors must be perpendicular to each other. Therefore AP vector, which is perpendicular to n vector. Therefore, from the figure, we have AP vector is perpendicular to n vector, where n vector is the normal to the plane. So, which is perpendicular to the plane here? If the two vectors are perpendicular, then their dot product is 0. So which is the condition we have obtained from the part of dot product of two vectors. So whenever two vectors are perpendicular to each other, then their dot product is 0. Therefore here AP and N vector, AP and N vector both are perpendicular to each other, then their dot product is 0. Hence we can take here AP dot n vector is equal to 0. Already we know that dot product of any two vectors which is equal to a scalar quantity, therefore it is equal to 0 here. Now AP vector can be written as here OP minus OA whole dot product with n vector is equal to 0. OP here replaced by r vector minus OA vector replaced by A vector dot product with n vector is equal to 0. So that it is the vector form of the plane which is passing through a point and having n vector as a normal to the plane. So it is here vector equation of the plane passing through a point and perpendicular to a given vector. So remember the students. Now we will go to find out the Cartesian form of the plane. For this, let us write the position vector of the arbitrary point, that is P vector, which is having the coordinates x, y, z. Therefore OP vector can be written as R vector is equal to xi plus yj plus zk. If A point has the coordinates x1, y1, z1 is the given point, then OA vector can be written as small a vector is equal to x1i plus y1j plus z1k. If A, B and C are the direction ratios of the normal vector n, then we can write that normal vector as ai plus bj plus ck. Now from the vector equation of the plane, we have r minus a whole dot n vector is equal to 0. Now replace the values of r, a and n here. So r value is equal to what here? That is xi plus yj plus zk. Therefore we can write here r minus m means we can take directly that subtraction. So that r minus m, that is x minus x1 whole into I plus y minus y1 whole into j plus z minus z1 whole into k. So which is dot product with ai plus bj plus ck, which is whole equal to 0. So students, it is a vector and it is also another vector, and whose dot product will be getting by doing the product of the scalar components of these two vectors, right? So x minus x1 into a is what here? X minus x1 into a plus y minus y1 into b plus z minus z1 into c is equal to 0. So which is only the Cartesian form of equation of plane which is passing through a point and perpendicular to a given vector. So remember this whole derivation, student. These both vector and Cartesian forms is asking for your annual examination for 5 marks. And now we start the problems on this part here. The question number 1, find the vector and Cartesian equations of the plane which passes through the point 5, 2, minus 4 and perpendicular to the line with direction ratios 2, 3, minus 1. Now for the solution here, just I am going to take this diagram here. So in this diagram, the three dimensional space having a plane, on that plane here that AP vector which is perpendicular to normal vector, that is n vector. Now we have to take the given data 5, 2, minus 4, these are the coordinates of the point mean through which that plane passes. So we can take that point as a point, therefore that a point has the coordinates 5, 2, minus 4. They can be taken as x1, y1, z1. That OA vector can be written as vector A, that is equal to 5i plus 2j minus 4k. Now the direction ratio of the plane, what are the direction ratios here? So perpendicular to the line with the direction ratio means, so these are the direction ratios of the normal, right? Therefore these can be taken as A, B, C. Therefore n vector can be written as 2i plus 3j minus k. So now we can write down the vector equation of the plane is r minus a whole into dot product with n vector is equal to 0. Now we can replace all the values here. So r minus a, so that r minus of a vector is what here? That is 5y plus 2j minus 4k, and which is whole dot product with n vector, that is 2i plus 3j minus k, which is whole equal to 0. So that it is only the vector equation of the plane for this given problem. Now we have to find out the Cartesian equation. So now consider these three coordinates are taken as already x1, y1, z1, and these are the ABC values, means direction ratios of the plane. Now Cartesian equation of the plane is given by x minus x1 into a plus y minus y1 into b plus z minus z1 into c is equal to 0. Therefore, we can replace the values here. X minus x1 is 5, x minus 5 whole into a is 2, plus y minus y1 value is what here? 2. So that y minus 2 whole into, that is 3, plus z minus of minus 4. So it becomes what here? Z plus 4 whole into minus 1, because the c value is minus 1 equal to 0. Now we can multiply and simplify this one here. This is 2 into x is 2x minus 2 into 5 is 10, plus 3 into y is 3y minus, because plus into minus is minus, 3 into 2 is 6, and next minus 1 into z is minus z, and minus 1 into 4 it is minus 4, it is equal to 0. Now we can make the simplification. So 2x plus 3y minus z minus 10 minus 6 minus 4. So all are having the minus signs here. After adding them here, it becomes minus 20 is equal to 0. So also we can write it as 2x plus 3y minus z equal to 20. So which is only the required Cartesian equation of the plane for this given problem. So students, remember this solution procedure. Similarly, here we will go for another example. Find the vector and Cartesian equation of the plane that passes through the point 1, 4, 6, and the normal vector to the plane is I minus 2 j plus k. Now consider the same diagram here. So again we consider the given data. So that plane passes through the point 1, 4, 6, therefore that can be taken as a point, has the coordinates 1, 4, 6. So these are the values of x1, y1, z1. So OA vector, which is position vector of the point A, so this can be taken as small a vector is equal to I plus 4j plus 6k by using the coordinates of the point A. Now from this data here, this is the normal vector to the plane, therefore this is n vector. It is already given directly. So n vector is equal to I minus 2j plus k. Now vector equation, it is given as r minus a whole dot product with n vector is equal to 0. So r minus a we can take directly here, right? Therefore r vector minus a vector is what? That is I plus 4j plus 6k whole dot product with n vector, that is I minus 2j plus 4k whole equal to 0. So this is the vector equation of the plane, and now we can find out the Cartesian form. So these are the x1, y1 and z1, and here we have a value is 1, b value is minus 2 and c value is 1. So that we have to consider only scalar component. So these are the direction ratios of the normal vector. Therefore, Cartesian form is given by x minus x1 whole into a plus y minus y1 whole into b plus z minus z1 whole into c is equal to 0. So this is the Cartesian form. Now we can replace the values and make the simplification. So x1, so that is what here 1, so that x minus 1 whole into the a value is 1 plus y minus 4 is here, so y minus 4 whole into b is what here minus 2 plus z minus 6 whole into 1 because the value of c is 1, so it is equal to 0. Now we can multiply and make the simplification. So 1 into x is x minus 1 into 1 is 1, minus 2 into y is minus 2y, minus 2 into minus 4 is plus 8, 1 into z is z, minus 6 into 1 is, that is minus 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, by simplification we can have, that is x minus 2y plus z, and minus 1 plus 8 minus 6 means it is whole equal to, that is here plus 1 is equal to 0, because minus 1 minus 6 is minus 7, plus 8 minus 7 is plus 1. Therefore x minus 2y plus z plus 1 is equal to 0. So which is the Cartesian form of equation of plane. So this is the solution for this given problem, that is question number 2. So based on this concept and problems, I am going to give that assignment number 6. So in this we have similar type of example. Therefore, you can solve all these examples and understand the concept. So in the next video, I am going to take that equation of the plane passing through three non-collinear points and also the problems. So we will continue in the next class. Thank you, students.